Obasanjo has not told me he wants to extend his tenure by 1 second unconstitutionally. And I do not think that I will do anybody's bidding, because I swore to uphold the constitution and to defend it.
The question of oil, it is wrong to think that because oil is in your backyard, therefore it belongs to you solely and alone. No, the answer is no. No.
I want to, anybody to correct me or to challenge me. No cocoa money was used in developing the oil industry. No granite pyramid money was used in developing the oil industry. The oil industry belonged to us.
And when you dispense, a pharmacist dispenses a drug to a patient, a doctor gives a drug to a patient, the name of the drug must be written on the envelope. Must. This 2-3 times a day, 1-2 times a day is unacceptable.
The zoos where animals are kept are better taken care of than people that are kept in prison.
As we count down to the 2007 general election, the country has witnessed a lot of political alignment, realignment, emergence of new political groupings and political parties. Recently, the Lieutenant General Jeremiah Useni led faction of the All Nigeria People's Party metamorphosed into a brand new party, the Democratic People's Party, DPP. What is the manifesto of this party all about? What does the party stand to give to Nigerians? Or what do Nigerians stand to benefit from this new party? All this and more on this edition of the program. You are watching Discourse. I'm Chinelo Bob Osamo. We will be joined by the national leader of Democratic People's Party, DPP, Lieutenant General Jeremiah Useni, retired. Stay with us. We'll be back after the break.
Discourse will be back in a moment. Stay tuned.
Shine your eye, shine your eye, shine well, well, well.
This one don't pass shine your eye so now that no go rest. Until perfect trust don't come up, pata pata for we country. Before you drink such a water, check date where them do am. Because why? Now that talk say, after 2 months, the water don't become disease be that. Any bread we no carry label. Hey, bros will buy. Because David don't use bromet where they cause cancer and kidney failure do am. Doctor, nurse, injection no better pass tablet too. Now only emergency or when person where they sick no fit swallow tablet. Now you fit give injection. If they give you medicine and them not write the name of the medicine, reject them. Because now you are right to know the medicine where you they collect. Bro say, now only the medicine where doctor write, now you feel buy. If you see person when one pour acid for person for the sake of say they be don't quarrel, report and care give now dark. No take your money buy waiting go kill you. If we stop to they buy medicine from all them people where they sell for road and inside bus, them bad business don't stop be that. No buy any products where no get NAFDAC restriction number, expiry date, plus including them and address of the manufacturer. Nigerian people, now only one life we get to, make we protect them well, well.
NAFDAC, safeguarding the health of the nation. Welcome back to Discourse.
General, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
While some Nigerians were still waiting and hoping for reconciliation among the factions in AMPP, your group came up with this bombshell, the Democratic People's Party. Why is that?
Well, because we couldn't reconcile. The other side made things very difficult. While we were talking reconciliation, we were doing other things which made it very, very impossible. First of all, they set up a reconciliation committee without discussing with us. Since that reconciliation committee headed by Alhaji Shinkafi, he came and I did put that question to him. I said, first, when we discussed this constitution some time ago, one of the governors was rude to you. We had to ask the governor to apologize to you. The situation was so bad that you yourself, you decided to resign your membership with the Board of Trustees of the party. Was that also? He said, yes. Then what the sudden change of event? In any case, who made you chairman of the reconciliation, knowing very well that there are two factions And these two factions never sat together. I heard one. Another way when we start to discuss setting up the conciliation, not alone to participate in selecting you as the chairman. In any case, since you have decided to come as a messenger, or my message, that unless the other side come and apologize for all the sins committed against this party, and also disband or regard what they did in Medjugorje null and void, then I don't see the way forward. Since that, I haven't heard anything. So there are no people you can reconcile with, as far as politics is concerned.
Are we seeing the end of All Nigerian People's Party? Because some governors are beginning to decamp to PDP.
Thank you very much. When we spoke, people thought we were just talking. Or probably maybe we were ambitious or thinking of other things else. We saw this some years ago, that the way things were going, the party will soon degenerate into a state that you cannot recover it. The party for quite some time has been property of Aso Rock, and that is why, as an opposition party, we never did what was expected of us. If the national chairman then could go to the public and announce publicly that anybody who thinks that this admission hasn't done well should have his head examined, then start wondering what our party will have. Oh, a party that is going to say third term will benefit MPP. When did MPP discuss that? They were all going to Aso Rock almost every evening. So we knew that the party was gone. And what is happening today is what we said before. Nothing new to us. Some governors are going, some senators have already left, House members, some have left, some on their way to leave. Some prominent party members are leaving. So, and with this irreconcilable attitude of the other side, definitely we cannot continue. So we'll form our own party. As far as we're concerned, PDP is now Cotonou.
What do you mean by that?
That means Gwenjo, second class cloth, second class vehicle that they buy across the border, Cotonou. That's what AMPP is now.
Okay, AMPP is now Cotonou.
Cotonou. Gwenjo. Yeah.
Yes. Why?
Well, because it's no good again. So we are now moving to a new era. We are not putting new clothes. We are not the campies. You only decamp to somebody's party. But when you form your own party, you don't decamp. We only change. We put this old cloth, which is no more useful again, and put on new cloth.
All right, tell us about Democratic People's Party.
Democratic People's Party. First of all, the name entails it means that we are the Democrats. People shouldn't confuse you with People Democratic Party. The other one is saying People Democratic Party, we don't know who are the people. We are saying we are the Democratic People's Party. That is one difference. Secondly, if you see our emblem, where we put pineapple. Pineapple is so sweet. Nobody will deny that. So the party itself is sweet.
What is the manifesto of this party like?
We have come up with a very good manifesto because we have taken into cognition all the ills of this country. Well, a very good manifesto. Anybody who will have the opportunity of seeing our manifesto, I have a copy here which we are giving to all our members and those who are interested to read, will see that we have mapped out very, very strategy how we handle agriculture, how we handle education, health, transport, etc. So definitely we are all out to give the country a new lease of life. We are all out to give the country better things, better program. We are determined to fulfill whatever promises we make to this country. And above all, we are committed to the obedience of the rule of law.
Now, talking about DPP, are you repositioning this party to win the election or to merely step into the shoe of AMPP as the strongest opposition party?
Well, we don't want to step into the shoes of anybody. Nobody sets up a party solely with the view of stepping into somebody's shoe, but to win election. That is our aim. But of course, everything comes from God. We will do our best to win the party. But in case we don't win the party, I mean we don't win the election, then of course we'll position ourselves in a position that will give very good account of ourselves, in a position that will give very credible opposition to whichever government is formed.
Hitherto, ANPP has been accused of being pro-North or a Northern political party. What efforts are your party members making to ensure that you have a spread and your nationalistic outlook?
Well, as the name entails, Democratic People's Party, we expect that those who are truly Democrat should join us to move this country together. We'll do everything we can. Most of the things will be unveiled during our, most of the details will be unveiled during our national luncheon. We intend to launch this party formally on the 28th of this month, some of the 28th of June. So some of the details will come up from there. But definitely, it's not going to be a regional party. It's going to be a national party.
Do you have some executive governors already in your party? Some members of National Assembly?
Well, we have one governor with us, Governor Bafarawa. I always tell people that having six governors on the other side and having one governor on my side does not mean that I'm a minority or I will not go far. After all, it's quality that matters, not quantity. I don't believe in quantity, quality that matters. And everybody knows Bafarawa is an astute politician. So it's quality that matters. For the National Assembly, I would say I have majority of them. For instance, the Senate, ANPP Senate leader then is on our side, Senator Olawo Ashaebu. You have sound senator like Dan Sadao.
Is he a member of the new party?
Yes, he's with us. Sule Gandhi, he's with us. And quite many of them, then you go to the house and find the house leader. He's with us.
Okay. Where are your offices apart from Abuja?
We have offices all over the country. Agreed, there are some area we're still trying to fix up because the other group must confess the whole, they're still holding to some areas. And where we see that they're holding to some area, we're opening up new offices. Okay. But where we're in control, it's a matter of changing dress. Okay. Remove this flag and put this flag. Remove this signboard and put this signboard. So that exercise is going on now. We couldn't do that earlier because we are waiting for approval. Now that we have got approved, we will now give them go ahead to start doing that exercise. So we'll soon meet to see the progress.
Okay, let us see about
it. But we have our national office properly positioned near Old Central Bank.
OCBN.
Here in Abuja. Yes, Abuja.
Okay. Let's see your program of activities. You say you are launching the party formally?
Yes, when the national caucus of then AMPP, because that was the day we told ourselves that 31st May is the last day we are holding a meeting as AMPP. Okay. That means from 1st June, we became DPP. Okay. So for the program we agreed during the next meeting on the 31st, or on the 28th of this month, we'll launch this party formally and officially so that the whole nation and our supporters internationally will know. And then 27 July to 2nd August, we shall be holding our congresses. Local government, world government, what local government and state. And then we'll go on further to hold meeting on the 8th So on the 9th of August, to ratify all those congresses, and then fix a date for the national convention, where we shall also select the national officers and our presidential. So we haven't fixed a date for the convention yet until we do those one. Okay. But definitely everything should be done. Everything should be completed by September.
Okay. Mm. You are currently the interim chairman.
I'm the leader.
You are the leader.
Yes, we have somebody holding post as
the national,
chairman. Who is that? Elijah Umaru Ahmed, former deputy governor of Bauchi State during NRC.
Okay. What assurance are you going to give Nigerians or people who intend to join the party that this party will not go the way of AMPP, being factionalized and maybe breaking into splinters again?
I can definitely say that with the help of God, I don't think we shall experience what we experienced in AMPP. Because this party is made up of like minds, of sincere people, people who want justice, people who want things done according to the constitution, that means due process, and people who fear God. Most of the chairmen that left us and went to the other side was because of what they were getting. In fact, what those people were doing was just calling people and be giving them money to put in their pocket, not that the chairmen were going to help even the parties. So some were going there because of what they get. But these are boys, apart from getting accommodation for them and small token for transportation, we never give them anything. Yet they were committed. They remain with us up to this minute. So I feel convinced that we have a good team that we are going to work with. And whosoever is coming to join us, once they see what we are doing, I think we will follow suit. Yes.
When new parties like this one emerge, the fear, most Nigerians fear that probably it is a front for one of the big shots who want to contest for presidential election.
That's why we're different. Mm-hmm. As I said, this DPP, if you talk a big shot, maybe the only governor I have, isn't it? Mm-hmm. I'm a big shot in my own right. What is it that I haven't been in this country except head of state? For the fact that I'm neither governor or senator or anything, doesn't mean I'm not a big shot. So I don't know what type of big shot they are interpreting. But definitely, we don't have any big shot in our party. I don't know what I'm telling you now. Governor Bafarawa is a serving governor. You know, we have past governors. I'm a past governor. I'm a past minister, I'm a past mayor, because this city is supposed to be mayority. So you have my likes. If you are talking of general, we have general also in my party. So those are big shots, if you are talking of big shots. So I don't know which big shot they are talking about again.
The known ones, the former head of state, who want to
come. Oh, yeah, talking of former head of state. Well, say so, because we talk of big shot. Big shot doesn't mean it's only former head of state.
That's right.
That's what I'm telling you. No. Who are the former head of state interested? IBB and Buhari. Mm-hmm. This party is not for any of them. But they are welcome if they want to join us. But we didn't form it for them. Neither did they have any part or play any part in the formation of this party called DPP or put any penny there. No. But that does not mean if they want to join us today, we will not welcome them. Just like anybody want to welcome. But I want to make it clear to all Nigerians that all these rumors that DPP, IBB has hand in it or whatever it is, no. Absolutely and true. The man is in PDP. If you talk of Buhari, it would have been better that Buhari is in MPP, so maybe you don't know which side he is, whether he's here or the other side. But IPP is not even in PDP. So what is wrong with people? Is it a shadow chasing people or something? Even when the man is sleeping, they're talking about him. He's in PDP.
Okay, the party just coming barely 1 year to the general election.
Yes.
What are your chances from
very bright
local government?
Very bright, very bright, very bright, because even the old parties, are they really prepared? Are they prepared? Has any party come up with a pressure candidate? Or can they come out to say this is their gubernatorial candidate? At best, we hear of aspirants. So we are not at any disadvantage at all. We are not at any disadvantage at all. For the fact that people are hearing a new name, that does not mean that the people inside are also new. So we're not at any disadvantage at all. We have equal opportunity, equal chances. We'll spring surprises. But we are better, man, because MPP only split into two. And one is now DPP. With many other people who didn't want to hear the name MPP, they are not joining us. They don't want to hear the name PDP, they are not joining us. PDP is split into four. MRDD came out from PDP. PPA from PDP. ACD from PDP. So what is left of the PDP, except those in government? How could they have advantage over us? So we're all moving on the same line.
Okay. Talk to Nigerians now. What is DPP going to offer? What is new? What are they going to offer to Nigerians?
One, I'm glad you say it's new. I know everybody look forward to getting new thing until start getting old. One, we tend to be very sincere to the people of Nigeria. We don't want to say one thing and do another. Two, we do things strictly according to the constitution. We cannot sway by the constitution to do this, we'll go and do another thing. No. Next to it is that we obey the rule of law. There are so many verdicts, so many cases concluded by the courts, which this administration has not lived up to expectation to respect such laws. We will not do that. We are respectful of law and order. We will make sure we give party security, no matter what we do. Unless you sleep with your two eyes closed, then they are not going anywhere. We are talking investment. What investment have we got in now? How many investment has a foreign partner brought in? When they read in the newspaper every now and then, their people are being adapted everywhere, every now and then, or being killed on the street here. And then you hear people being killed. You hear that the IG is leading the investigation personally, as if tomorrow you hear a result. You don't hear anything. Look at the marshals. Look at the boy again, number one law officer in this country. And I can go on and count so many of them. Nothing come. How can we live in a situation like that? We're not saying that we eliminate this thing completely to zero. But at least we'll show people that what come across, something is done about it. And I think that will really reduce it. We have to spread out development. There's no area that should be regarded as a Nango area, or that area is stupid, or that we don't need it. Even a fool is needed. We don't know when a fool will make you happy by laughing. Next, we make sure people are healthy. How are people healthy? How would they be healthy? We're making sure that the hospitals are up to date. You can't reach agreement with the doctors. You are going to do this. The next thing, you don't get on such agreement. It's only with education. You don't reach agreement with the, what you know you cannot do, tell them straight away you cannot do. But you can't reach agreement the following day, you renegate on such agreement. I mean, there must be mutual trust between government or the government and the governed. We are taking note of all those. Some of these are already contained in our manifesto. But of course, you cannot write everything, just like constitution. Just like Bible, you cannot write everything in there. But these are some of the things we are going to do. Make sure the security, make sure hospitals live up to expectation by equipping them very well. Make sure our education are respectable all over the world, like those years where you get your university degree, you go overseas, you are respected. Today, you have to take another exam again. My daughter had to go through that in the US. To take another exam and pass. Before they believe that she got a university degree in Nigeria. I mean, why should this thing be? So of course, there must be food for all. There must be food for all. Housing, for instance. Sometimes we are talking of housing for everybody by 2000. Before we go there, another thing altogether. Today, they are demolishing people's houses under the guise of keeping the country or the town to original plan and all this. And then even where the government build houses, they are selling it to people at exorbitant prices that the civil servant cannot afford. So whom are you really helping? Employment. Unless you revamp the industries and create a situation whereby foreign investors come in to boost our economy, we'll continue to have this employment. And more and more people are coming from university to add to this army of the unemployed. So we're not talking of battalion of the unemployed, we're not talking of brigade or division or corps, we're talking of armies of unemployment. Something has to be done about it. We shouldn't just play lip service, but most importantly, what government cannot do, be sincere, be fair to tell people, we cannot do this thing, come, let's do it together. But don't pretend.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, viewers, that is it on today's edition of the program. Do keep a day's results same time next week. Have a wonderful week ahead.